This new SEAT multipurpose vehicle, or MPV, is the result of intense teamwork between two big names in the design and manufacture of automobiles, Volkswagen and Ford. The vehicle is marketed by SEAT, Volkswagen and Ford, but with slight variations to emphasize the personality of each brand. Charan is the name of the Volkswagen version, Galaxy is the Ford, and the SEAT is the Alhambra. Joint cooperation resulted in Volkswagen being responsible for the technical research and development work in Germany at Wolfsburg, while Ford concentrated on the logistics and production. The vehicles are manufactured in one of the most modern automobile factories in Europe, at Palmela in Portugal. A new company, Auto Europa, was founded especially for the MPV production and is owned jointly by Volkswagen and Ford. The Alhambra's impressive performance owes much to its aerodynamic design. The bonnet and windscreen follow one continuous line, while the headlights are designed to blend into the body contours. These styling details all help to contribute to the low drag coefficient of 0.31, which is outstanding for a vehicle of this category. The Alhambra's interior is exceptionally roomy, and a variety of seating arrangements is possible. The seats are secured by simple-to-operate catches and can therefore be easily removed and refitted to suit a variety of requirements. The Alhambra stands out for its comfort and versatility. It can be converted from a comfortable sitting area to an active person's dream or an enjoyable travelling vehicle. The front seats are fitted with folding tables and a storage pouch. Optional child safety seats can also be ordered. The Alhambra is very versatile when it comes to transporting loads. As a two-seater, it has a load capacity of 3.2 cubic meters or a payload of 700 kilograms. That's double the amount of a large estate car. To make full use of the interior space, the spare wheel is mounted under the floor. It's suspended on a cable mechanism, which for security can only be released from the inside. When the cable's fully slackened, the retainer must be pushed up slightly before it can be turned and detached from the wheel. Before starting any repair work, it's important to correctly identify the vehicle from the chassis number, which is located in the engine compartment. To release the bonnet catch, first pull the lever inside the vehicle, and then lift the bonnet slightly in order to push on the safety catch. The chassis number is located here. However, for routine service work, you should find the data sticker in the passenger compartment more helpful, as it catalogues more detailed information. It lists production control code, chassis number, model code, vehicle model and version, engine output and gearbox type, engine code, gearbox code, paint code, interior trim code, and the numbers which identify the factory-fitted options. Incidentally, the chassis number can also be found on this sticker on the passenger's side door pillar. And you'll find it again here, in the dashboard area by the windscreen. The Alhambra is available with two well-proven engines, a petrol and a diesel. The diesel is the well-known 1.9-litre 90 brake horsepower TDI unit from the Toledo. The four-cylinder petrol engine is of 2 litres capacity, develops 115 brake horsepower, and is fitted with the CMOS engine management system. The system features sequential injection and uses fewer components than the Digifant system it replaces. The intake air is measured by a hot film type air mass sensor. The hot wire element, together with its air temperature sensor, is positioned in a bypass duct. The duct increases the airspeed passing over the sensor and makes it less likely to be affected by back pulses. Due to the higher airspeed and the fact that the hot wire element is encapsulated in a glass film, the sensor is less prone to soiling and thus does not require the burn-off sequence used by earlier types of hot wire sensors. A separate sensor for measuring intake temperature is mounted in the side of the air filter housing. The hall sender distributor provides the control unit with an initial recognition signal for cylinder number one. The signal is predominantly used by the ECU for cylinder selective knock control. The engine is fitted with one knock sensor. The engine speed and crank angle are measured by a crankshaft sensor. The pulse generator wheel at the rear of the crankshaft provides RPM signals, and a gap in the teeth indicates the TDC position of cylinders 1 and 4. Unlike previous inductive sensors, this one is of the Hall effect type. It uses two Hall generators in one housing, together with a permanent magnet. Its design reduces the likelihood of the sensor being affected by temperature and mechanical wear. This engine is also equipped with exhaust gas recirculation, or EGR as it's known. A newly developed throttle valve control device has been introduced. It incorporates an idle switch and two throttle potentiometers and is likely to appear on a number of other engines in the near future. To regulate the idle speed, the unit uses an electric motor and gears to control the movement of the throttle butterfly in the nearly closed position. A specially shaped throat allows precise regulation of the airflow at idle speed. This enables small changes to the airflow quantity to be made for relatively large movements of the throttle valve. The two potentiometers inform the engine ECU about the throttle valve's angle and the movement of the electric motor. A fail-safe design means that the engine can maintain a fixed but acceptable idle speed in the event of an electrical failure. Most electrical faults which are likely to occur with the component and its wiring can be recognized by the self-diagnosis system of the engine's ECU. The system can, of course, be interrogated using the VAG 1551. The CMOS engine management system is equipped with self-diagnosis and responds to the following VAG 1551 function codes. 01, interrogate control unit version. 02, interrogate fault memory. 03, final control diagnosis. 04, introduction of basic setting. 05, erase fault memory. 06, end output. 07, code control unit. 08, read measuring value block. 09, read individual measuring values. 10, adaptation. And 11, login. In the event of the engine control unit requiring replacement, then the new control unit must be coded correctly. Full details can be found in the repair manual. The TDI diesel engine's glow plug system is now triggered initially by a signal from the driver's door courtesy light switch. This reduces the time the driver has to wait before starting a cold engine. This power unit also features new mountings, which work on the pendulum principle. The engine and transmission are suspended at either end, which means that the assembly can move in response to the engine's torque, the maximum movement being limited by a stabilizer. The overall effect is reduced vibration. To shorten the engine's warm-up phase and reduce noise, the radiator is fitted with a thermostatic vane-type blind. When cold, the vanes are closed, thereby restricting the airflow. As the engine compartment temperature increases, the wax-filled thermostat slowly expands and the flaps are progressively opened. All manual gearbox versions of the Alhambra are fitted with the 006 transmission. Its key features are its high torque capacity combined with low internal running resistance. All gears run on low friction needle roller bearings, and the use of low viscosity automatic transmission fluid helps to reduce the effort required for gear shifting, particularly in cold weather. It's a two-shaft unit with synchromesh on all gears, including reverse. First, second and third gears feature dual synchros. Gear selection is performed by two maintenance-free precision Bowden cables. One cable moves the linkage across the gate, whilst the other selects the gears. Reverse gear, incidentally, can be selected only after first lifting the collar. Should it be necessary to replace a cable at any time, then note that they should only ever be replaced as a pair. When detaching the cables at the gearbox end, disconnect them from their levers by applying pressure directly onto the respective end pieces, by using a screwdriver, for example. Before releasing the cables from the gear lever, secure it first with the special locating tool. The cables are disconnected by sliding back the locking sleeves. Thanks to the special tool, which sets the lever into the neutral position, the adjustment of the gear lever is done automatically on reassembly. By the way, the combined transmission oil level and filler plug is situated on the front of the casing. The Alhambra is available with the 4-speed AG4 automatic transmission with torque converter lockup on third and top gears. As the transmission is electronically controlled, the ECU is responsible for the electrical and hydraulic functions. It features an adaptive gear shift program which adapts to the driver's most recent driving style and can even recognize load increases such as hill climbing, towing, and headwinds. Due to its advanced design, the control unit receives speed information from three different sources: gearbox revs from the sun wheel of the planetary set, road speed from the transmission's output shaft, and engine RPM. To improve gear shifting, the engine ECU receives a signal from the transmission control unit to instruct it to reduce engine torque when changing gear. Various driving styles were used as the basis for the transmission's dynamic shift program, which features fuzzy logic control. Fuzzy means indistinct. For example, in addition to the categories of blue and red, or hot and cold, decisions have to be taken which lie between the two. For instance, there are numerous degrees between cold and hot, such as cool, lukewarm, warm, or very hot. The exact value is recognized by the fuzzy logic on the basis of the ratio of blue to red area. A temperature of 10 degrees Celsius, for example, is assigned 90% to the cold area and 10% to the hot area. The fuzzy logic registers almost cold. It's a similar situation with regard to economical or sporty driving characteristics. The fuzzy logic recognizes the sporty element on the basis of how quickly the accelerator pedal is depressed. A sport factor of zero is equivalent to 0% sporty driving, in other words, an extremely economical driving style. A sport factor of one, on the other hand, equates to 100% sporty driving style. The sport element then provides a basis for the selection of the gear change points on a variable scale between economical and performance driving styles. An infinite number of shift points are thus possible between economy and sport. A 30% sport factor, for instance, relates to 30% sport and 70% economy, thereby permitting a more sensitive reaction to the choice of driving style. The automatic transmission incorporates torque converter lockup. As the torque converter acts as a fluid flywheel, it normally has the disadvantage of converter slip with increasing engine speed. However, when the lockup clutch is activated, the engine power is transmitted mechanically and the converter is practically disengaged. The control unit decides when to operate the lockup clutch depending upon input signals. The clutch is then activated by the control unit, energizing a solenoid in the valve block. When the lockup clutch is disengaged, the ATF fluid flows via duct A to the front of the clutch and via duct B to the clutches of the planetary gearbox. To engage the clutch, the solenoid moves the valve mechanism so that the ATF fluid is directed via duct C into the converter and behind the lockup clutch. Simultaneous opening of duct A allows pressure to bleed from the area in front of the clutch to accelerate its engagement. To disengage the clutch, the valves are moved to allow the ATF to flow via duct A into the area in front of the clutch, and duct C is closed. This increases the pressure in front of the lockup clutch to disengage it. Another innovation is that it's now possible to replace the valve block's printed circuit foil, although do make sure that the special tool is used to prevent damage when doing so. If the transmission has to be removed at any time, then you'll require the special workshop tool to support the engine. Detailed instructions on its use can be found in the repair manual. The self-diagnosis system of the AG4 transmission also enables dynamic tests to be performed in addition to the more usual fault diagnosis functions. The suspension and braking system of the Alhambra provide high standards of both comfort and safety. The front suspension is of a new design and uses coil springs and McPherson struts, located at their lower ends by triangulated wishbones. These are mounted on a subframe, which also supports the engine. Its design means that far less road and engine noise reaches the passenger compartment. All Alhambra models are fitted with power-assisted rack and pinion steering, and a column, adjustable for height and reach, is standard across the range. The steering lock incorporates a new anti-theft feature using a clutch-like device. If the wheel is forced, the locking device starts to slip on the column, thus preventing the lock from being destroyed. From a service point of view, only the toe is adjustable on the front suspension, and this must be corrected equally on both track rods. The rear suspension is mounted on a tubular subframe attached to the body by large rubber bushes. The suspension uses semi-trailing arms, coil springs, and gas-filled dampers to provide the best combination of handling characteristics over the wide range of load variations likely to be encountered in multi-purpose use. Its design means that it can also accommodate a rear drive axle for vehicles with four-wheel drive. Although there are no provisions for routine alignment corrections, it is possible by a service solution to correct the rear camber and toe. This involves installing a bonded rubber bush with an eccentric sleeve to the inner wishbone mounting. The exact details can be found in the service literature. All models are fitted with diagonally split dual-circuit brakes with discs front and rear. To prevent premature braking of the rear wheels, all vehicles, other than those with ABS, are fitted with an inertia pressure-limiting valve. The valve causes the brake pressure in the rear brakes to rise more slowly than that of the front. ABS brakes with ventilated front discs are available as an option. The Teves Mark IV GI ABS system has a combined modulator and control unit assembly. The system uses 4 wheel speed sensors and 3 hydraulic circuits. This means that each front wheel is braked independently, while the rear brakes are regulated together. In spite of the joint regulation, each rear brake is supplied by a separate pipe. The modulator, or valve block, has 8 solenoid valves, that's 4 inlet and 4 outlet. One pair of valves regulates the pressure to each front brake, while the rear brakes are simultaneously regulated by 2 pairs of valves working together. The ABS system incorporates electronic brake force distribution, which eliminates the need for a rear brake pressure regulator. Instead, information supplied by the wheel speed sensors is used by the ABS control unit to regulate the pressure to the rear brakes by activating the relevant solenoids in the modulator unit. For additional safety, the ABS and the electronic brake force distribution functions are kept separate within the control unit, so in the event of a failure, either system can work independently. As the driver is provided with 2 warning lights, ABS and brake warning, it's important for you to understand their function. The ABS lamp should light when the ignition is switched on and go out when the self-check has been passed. If the lamp remains lit or comes on at any other time, then the ABS system is inoperative and the cause must be investigated. The brake warning lamp has several functions. Firstly, like the ABS lamp, it should light when the ignition is switched on and go out once the self-check is complete. It will likewise light if the brake fluid level is low, the handbrake is on, or the electronic brake force distribution function is inoperative. The first step when fault-finding the ABS system is to check the operation of the warning lights, as it can help you initially in locating the fault area. For in-depth fault finding, the system has self-diagnosis, which is accessed with the VAG 1551. The diagnostic functions include fault memory interrogation, final control diagnosis for activating components of the modulator unit, and the measuring block mode for the reading and monitoring of values, including wheel speed sensors, etc. You'll need to refer to the repair manual, however, for detailed diagnosis information. The heating and ventilation system is fitted with a pollen or particulate filter, which to a great extent stops industrial pollution, road dust and pollen from entering the interior. The heater controls are similar to those of other SEAT models, although one new feature is the recirculation function to reduce fumes entering the vehicle when in traffic. Pressing the blower switch activates the function, the warning light indicating when air recirculation is selected. The 7-seater models have additional heating for the rear passengers. A dash-mounted switch switches the system on or off, while separate controls in the rear enable the blower speed and temperature to be regulated. The temperature controller operates an electric motor, which in turn moves a flap to regulate the mix of warm and cold air. The heater unit is behind the left-hand wheel arch panel. Manual air conditioning is a standard feature, while electronically controlled climatronic is an option. For the first time on a SEAT vehicle, an electrically heated windscreen is available. Controlled by a switch on the dashboard, the screen is turned off automatically after about 4 minutes to save energy. Heated and electrically operated external mirrors are also available. The Alhambra's comprehensive instrument panel is clear and functional. Depending upon the model, it can include service interval reminder, tachometer, multifunction indicator, low ambient temperature warning, bulb failure warning, and doors open warning. These are in addition to the more standard warning lamps for alternator, oil pressure, screen wash fluid, airbag, and so on. Controls for headlights, indicators, and wipers are incorporated into the newly designed stalks on either side of the steering wheel, as are the switches for the multifunction indicator. The horn buttons, by the way, are just here. In contrast to previous versions, the multifunction indicator no longer includes outside air temperature and clock functions. The clock is mounted separately in the roof panel, and the air temperature function is included within the instrument panel warning lights. The left-hand symbol warns when the temperature has dropped to between +4 and 1 degrees Celsius, and the one on the right lights at temperatures below freezing. Other new features include a low fuel level warning lamp within the gauge, the permanent illumination of the instrument panel whenever the ignition is on. The instrument panel is provided with onboard self-diagnosis, accessible with the VAG 1551. It can interrogate the fault memory, perform final control diagnosis to check the instrument functions, and call up the measuring value block to verify readings and sensor outputs, etc. You'll find the connection socket for the 1551 beneath the front ashtray. Removal of the instrument panel is straightforward. The first step is to remove the trim followed by the two screws securing the panel. The instrument housing can then be pulled out, not forgetting to disconnect the wiring plugs, of course. Behind the panel are the control units of the engine management, immobilizer, and auxiliary warning systems. The immobilizer control unit is only visible from below. The combined fuse box and main relay plate is behind the lower part of the dashboard, while a separate relay under the bonnet controls the radiator fan. New for SEAT is the position of the radio aerial. It's incorporated into the rear side window. Attention to detail in the Alhambra is reflected by refinements such as the auxiliary power sockets provided in the rear of the vehicle for powering equipment such as a portable computer, hot or cold picnic box, or a portable TV. All models also feature excellent interior lighting. The roof lights are automatically switched on when the ignition key is removed or whenever the vehicle is unlocked. The lights go out when the ignition is turned on, the vehicle's locked from the outside, or after a 20-second delay. The timer is integrated within the central locking and anti-theft control unit, found beneath the front passenger seat. The windscreen wipers are unique. To clear the maximum area, the two wiper arms are widely spaced and have curved blades which overlap in the centre. Irrespective of the speed setting, the blades always slow down on approaching the bottom of the screen to allow them to park more precisely and improve the driver's vision. Added to this, all models have the now familiar intermittent wipe function and heated screen washer jets. The Alhambra is fitted with an engine immobiliser system, which in principle works the same as that of the Ibiza. It comprises ignition key with integrated transponder, inductive reading coil surrounding the steering lock, immobiliser control unit, and the engine management control unit. The transponder, which works by induction and thus doesn't require a battery, is programmed with a unique permanent code. On starting the engine, the immobiliser control unit sends a voltage signal via the reading coil to the transponder. The transponder answers by transmitting its permanent code back to the control unit. The control unit compares the incoming code with that stored in its memory to ensure that they match. The immobiliser then compares a second, random code sent from the engine management control unit with that stored in its memory. If all the codes match, the engine continues to run. If they don't, then the control unit switches the engine off after roughly 2 seconds. After every successful engine start, the random code stored in the immobiliser's memory is erased. A new code, produced by a random code generator in the engine control unit, is then sent to the immobiliser, where it is once again stored for comparison on the next engine start. This random code, which changes on each engine start, prevents a potential thief from bypassing the immobiliser system. An LED indicator lamp, which is also utilised by the anti-theft system, provides a functional check of the immobiliser system. Normally, the LED lights on turning on the ignition and goes out shortly after engine starting. But if after turning on the ignition the light flashes rapidly, it indicates that there is a fault. On occasions, this can be attributable to the immobiliser not recognising the key, possibly due to a customer buying a spare key and forgetting to have the immobiliser control unit reprogrammed to match the new key. Key programming is something with which you may already be familiar, but if it's new to you, here briefly is how it's done. To begin with, make sure you have the immobiliser's secret code number to hand. It's under the peel-off area of the tag, which is attached to the keys when the vehicle is supplied new. It's important for security reasons that the tag is removed by the customer when collecting the car new and that it's kept in a safe place for future reference. Having connected the 1551 and switched on the ignition, choose Rapid Data and enter the address code 25. Enter function code 11 and then key in 0 plus the 4-digit secret number. Next, select function code 10, followed by channel number 01. At this point, the screen displays the number of ignition keys currently recognised by the control unit, in this instance, 3. Use the arrow key to move the display onto the next screen. You now key in 4 zeros, plus the number of keys you wish the immobiliser to recognise. Up to a maximum of 8 keys is possible. Even if you are adding just one additional key, all the keys must be matched together. Press Q once to move on, and then again to confirm the number of selected keys. Press Q once again to store the changed value. Use the arrow key to go forward to the function menu, from where you can end the output by entering code 06. At this point, the key which is in the ignition lock is matched to the immobiliser. So to match other keys, remove the first and insert the second. switch on the ignition, turn it off again, insert the next, and so on. Repeat the process for the remaining keys, remembering that they must all be inserted within 30 seconds. Oh, and if by chance the customer has lost or misplaced the secret number, then you'll need to contact the importer, who should be able to obtain it for you. They'll most probably first need the immobiliser's identification number. It can be found either by looking on the control unit's sticker or by interrogating the control unit version with the VAG 1551. SEAT will, of course, require some proof of ownership. The 1551 is also used to interrogate and erase the immobiliser's fault memory and to enter the adaptation mode. The adaptation mode must be entered after replacing either the engine or immobiliser control units. If not, the engine will be prevented from starting. Please refer to the repair manual for details on this and the other 1551 functions, however. The central locking system, featuring both single locking and secure locking functions, is a completely new development for SEAT. Firstly, there are no locking buttons on the inside of the doors, and secondly, the system is totally electrically operated. The doors are locked from the inside simply by pushing the handle. This single locks the doors. That means that they can't be opened from the outside, but can from the inside. If, on the other hand, the vehicle is locked from the outside with just a single turn of the key, then it's secure locked or double locked. The doors can't be opened from either inside or outside. This feature provides a high level of security as it prevents entry even after a window has been smashed. Remember, though, that it's inadvisable to apply the secure locking function when leaving occupants in the vehicle. If required, you can single lock the car from the outside by turning the key twice within 2 seconds. For added safety, a crash sensor within the control unit automatically unlocks the doors during a crash. In the event of a central locking failure, the fuel filler flap can be released from inside the rear compartment. The central locking system comprises control unit beneath the left front seat, door courtesy light switches, front exterior door handle operated micro switches, LED in the driver's door, and the door lock motor assemblies. The four door locks have two electric motors within each assembly. On single locking, just one motor is driven to operate the lock. On secure locking, the first motor works the lock as described, and the second motor disconnects the lock from the interior handle's operating cable. The flashing LED in the driver's door indicates that the secure locking function is activated and the alarm is set. To ease fault finding, the central locking system incorporates self-diagnosis, which is accessible by using the 1551. Additional security is provided by the door lock barrels, which include ratchet devices. If an attempt is made to unlock the door using a screwdriver or an incorrect key, the barrels rotate without engaging the lock mechanism, thereby preventing the locks from being torn from their housings. The SEAT Alhambra naturally reflects the high standards of safety associated with all SEAT vehicles. The body is based on a ladder-type frame, which provides the foundation for good torsional resistance, and precisely defined crumple zones reduce the danger of serious injury. Other safety features included are a specially designed steering column, which reduces the extent to which it is pushed back into the passenger compartment in a collision, doubly reinforced doors, pyrotechnic self-tensioning front seat belts, airbag, front and rear bumpers capable of absorbing minor impacts without damage, and a front passenger airbag as standard on the top of the range models. These measures ensure that the Alhambra not only complies but already surpasses all crash regulations, including the stringent US 35 miles per hour frontal crash instead of the more usual 30 mph requirement. The Alhambra is also subjected to rear-end crash tests, which are designed to ensure that the vehicle already complies with likely forthcoming legislation. Incidentally, when placing the vehicle on a workshop hoist, please note that the lifting points are different to those of other models. With the Alhambra, SEAT makes a strong entry into the MPV market. It's a prestigious vehicle with futuristic concepts and one which demands customer service of the highest standard. The SEAT Alhambra is a vehicle which has been designed right from the start to be enjoyed. It's important, therefore, for all of us in the service department to provide the customer with the best possible service.